Hello, ladies and gents, guys and girls, friendly femmes and fellows all. Welcome back to Genoa as we once again don the green finery of our Italian friends.
Yes.
We were last time in the middle of taking on Sardinia and the Spanish in the southern swaths of Italy. But we shall start with the island fortress here.
Who do I face? No, I cannot go there.
We shall send where Captain Elfgar stands against us with musketeers and a bit of reconnaissance cavalry. We have cannons, we have guns, we have pikes. We have just a better army than them in every single regard. So let's see what we can do. We shall start by bombarding them with cannon fire, and from then on it'll be anyone's guess.
The battle goes our way. Let's pray it remains as such.
Okay, what can we do? What can we do? Yeah, I suppose this is the slope. If we're gonna get in, we're gonna get in this way. That's how it's gonna be. It should be you and me. Okay. They stand in the square, as they are wont to do. And the gates are down.
Our enemy's gates are down!
Which is excellent. Now we just have to waltz in, I suppose. Now, I'm thinking that let's start by moving in our cannons. They might start to make noises towards, you know, getting out and doing something against what we're perpetrating. But as such, I think I'll keep it to the melee forces in here. We won't do ourselves any favours by getting caught in a lot of, you know, missile exchange within these confines, where we can't really use our massive number of guns to our advantage. But what we can use is our cavalry in tight quarters, we can use our pikes in tight quarters, and we can use our cannons to potentially shell the enemy. Although I don't think we'll be able to get at them from where we are. But let's just see what they do as we move our troops in.
Our soldiers have proved their worth today. The enemy's walls belong to us now.
Here come the pikes. So, from what angle could we feasibly do some damage? This one, I suppose. What are they doing? They're just milling about in the center. Let's get our cannons over here. Let's get our melee forces over here. We'll have to take them the long way around. Ah, and the gunners come at us, so let's run to meet them. They're not gonna like that. Lord damn it! No. That wasn't very good.
It is unwise to praise the day before sunset.
Oh well.
Our men are winning the battle and forging a worthy victory.
One should never forget that this game has, yeah, it's as if their armor just isn't even there. So the tankiness that the bodyguards used to have, even in the base game, I would say it was limited, but I mean, it's nothing compared to the paperweight of the enemy in these circumstances. And now they're even beating the cavalry. I mean, how are they even doing that? That's not supposed to be possible. I guess that's choke points for you. I'll try to see if I can mash my troops into them. Maybe disrupt the formation just slightly. Preparing for the pikes to arrive, but I mean, at this rate, those musketeers, they're not meant to be great melee fighters, but here they are, they're besting my troops. So let's try to push through. A glorious death, well, quite.
Unwise to praise the day before sunset, but our men are winning the battle and forging.
Come on, get down those pikes if you can. Come on, don't just let those damn musketeers. I mean, man, they are giving us something to think about. I'll have to concede that. My thinking was that I wanted to stop them from shooting, but it seems to me now that having them shoot at me would have been a better outcome than this.
They have lost half their men.
What? Ugh. We're just gonna run them down with these guys. Come on! Okay then.
It is unwise to praise the day before sunset, but our men are winning the battle and forging a worthy victory.
Get in there. No, that's not what you're meant to be doing. Wavering. Fools. Okay. I mean, this is just when we take... I think that's what when common musketeers have the same basically the same defense stat as the bodyguard unit. I'm not wholly convinced that's the best way to go about it.
It is unwise to praise the day before
and
sunset,
it does annoy me slightly.
Winning the battle and forging a worthy victory.
I mean, pikes are good because of their animation, but it seems that when they have so low defense, that then they don't really get to use it all that well. Because the enemy closed the distance in a matter of seconds.
Praise the day before sunset, but our men have fought long and are becoming tired.
And then their pikes are for naught, and they become basically sword units when they should be using pikes. So, yeah. And now we're just losing so many troops and trying to take this bloody place. It's not meant to be this difficult.
Like the coward he is. Press onward and break the spirit of his army.
Jesus, our men are just running and running and running, and they're just, yeah.
By the curses, our men no longer command the praise to our... The enemy general has no honor.
Finally.
He flees the field of battle and abandons his men.
What else do they have left? Where is the enemy? What? That's a bit weird.
There we go. Clear victory that goes to
Jesus, 35% lost. I'm not too thrilled about it. Marco de Alba.
Noble Lord, we have conquered.
Okay, so what now? Turn the turn. I forgot. I was so upset I even forgot to do the attack on Spain. They want me to blockade the port of Valencia. Okay then. I guess so. Hello, Brits. What are you up to? Farewell. A chapel, maybe? Sure, why not? Okay. I'll tell you why not, because we need the money elsewhere. We need subsistence farming, maybe? Yeah. In Sardinia. Subsistence farming also, yes, that is excellent.
You want us gone? Then do something about it.
Okay. Okay. Let's get the bad taste of that Pyrrhic victory. Out of our mouths. So we have our cannons. They might man the walls, and if they do, they'll be shot. So where do we have them? On the walls, indeed. Okay, let's go for this section of the wall. Fire! Nah, okay. Didn't fire on time. then prioritize something else.
The walls fall.
Okay, that's that wall.
It's time to charge men through to slay our ungodly foe.
How will they take that, I wonder? Maybe, maybe we should attack this section of wall. This cannot, this unit cannot attack buildings? What? I mean, come on, that's what it's designed to do.
Excellent! We have breached our enemy's walls.
Ah, and killed a couple of them in the process. That is very satisfying to see. Okay then. Let's move in. Thinking that I'll put some missile units on the walls, shoot at them for a bit.
Give grace to God.
We'll have our melee troops down there. Walls. Our cannons will come in. I'll just walk over there, I think. As will the generals. Ah, okay. They run away. Okay then. New plan. And we surround them. That'll be the gist of it. I don't like the look of this road. Doesn't provide the best angle. This one's fine. This one's fine. And this one is a bit short of the distance, but it's fine. They'll be ready to stand in. Okay. Bombard, you go over there. Rifle militia, you go over there. Let's just take that. Pikes behind the guns, the cannons, and the guns in front of the cannons. It's all going to be nice and lovely. I assure you. What are you doing? You're supposed to go in there. Ugh. Now you're being attacked by pikemen now. Ugh. It's not going according to plan! But I suppose we can use this regardless. Uh, and now you want to move ahead. I mean, Jesus, the timing of you guys, it's...
The battle is in our favor. If we remain true and wholehearted, victory...
And you, again, you use your damn swords instead of your pikes. That really does my nut in. You're in spear wall formation. God damn it. That's incredible.
The enemy are badly blooded. They have lost half their men.
Okay.
We are praise the Almighty. Our enemy has lost his stomach to fight. We must all of Christendom will be all.
Okay, slightly better victory. Foolishness of pikemen notwithstanding.
The day is ours. The enemy are
Regium is captured.
Lord, we have conquered.
Let us get ourselves a recruitment office. And let's continue on our merry journey.
Yes, my lord.
Take Agrigento. You're on Sicilia. This is a bit better defended, more well defended, and of course a castle.
Yes.
Which
they're going nowhere, my lord.
Might do my nut in, but let's see. Count Catalano. Catalano would be Spanish, and Catalano, I believe, is Italian pronunciation.
Yes?
But I would love to be corrected on that assumption. So, Count Catalano against Hernan. Let's save it and get to work. And once again, it's one of these castles, isn't it? Yeah. It's a very annoying castle to attack. Because they'll just always stand up there and there's no real walls to use. There's no great vantage point from which you can attack the square in ranged combat. Which makes it, of course, an ideal place to defend, but makes it a horrendous place to try and take with any real efficiency. I suppose we can try to get our troops up here and shoot down at them. I guess that's our best bet. We'll put some troops over there, I think. And now we fire, and the gates should fall. Excellent. Okay. Let's get the cannons in. I'll be taking the long way around. Same as last time. We'll see if they can get anything done this time around. I'll take... Yales. It'll be pretty much the same thing with these gunners. We have our pikemen. Oh, okay. They're coming to meet us. What are they coming to meet us with? Spearmen! Okay. Let's see if we can get. Maybe we can just lure them down there and then we can have some trusty old riflemen pluck away at them from up here.
give grace to God. We have captured the enemy's walls.
And there is a lot of infantry coming our way. Okay, these cannons, they can just stay there. Okay. Shoot them, please. Nah, damn it. They got control of the towers. It's annoying. At least we caught their grenadiers. Let's get you guys up there. It's not the best situation this, but we'll have to make do. We'll put ourselves in the walls if we can. Oh Jesus, they're coming in force. Okay. They're kind of running away, which means that we must seize the initiative with our cavalry and try to catch whatever we can on the way back to the square. Now they're just... Yeah, okay, go. Come on. Get them.
Only half the enemy force remains.
Nice. Okay. Now we will try to take the square with our cavalry and hold it. That should get them to come back. Yes, 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 yes. Okay, good. So let's take all these troops and just run at those guys. Home Guard militia. And musketeers.
It is unwise to praise the day before sunset, but our men are winning the battle and forging a worthy victory.
Jesus. A single spearman just creating a huge problem.
The battle is in our favor if we remain true and hold.
Damn, okay. You can't take that. Yes! We broke them. Okay, good. Okay. That should be Cecilia in our hands now. Which is excellent. And what do they have?
This place is yours, my lord.
They have an engineering building, naval base, rural roads, and a drill plaza. Excellent, excellent, excellent.
Yes. Your name orders.
Let's take this guy and just establish a bit of sight range on this island.
Orders.
Nice. And then we have a French foes. Okay.
Orders. Your Majesty. Yes. Your Majesty.
So
a good day's march ends.
Catalan.
Your will.
Okay. So this guy, Django Balan. He will go back to Genoa. Marshal whatever forces will be there, and he'll push west into Marseille, I think.
Yes. Orders.
Let's see what we can merge here.
Your Majesty. Orders. Yes. Orders. Your Majesty. Yes. Orders.
Let's get ourselves a frigate, maybe. Do we have anywhere that can construct a more advanced vessel? No, we don't really. That's okay.
Move out.
Thank you. They're going for an economic and cultural policy down here. Sure.
Orders?
You should face trial for heresy.
I love you too. Okay. So we build a frigate here. And then, yeah, so Balan, he will traverse by foot, because on his fast steed he can get there pretty quickly. And then we'll train a boat to go and pick up, maybe we'll actually train a couple, to go and pick up Count Catalano and his forces, merge them with the forces in Sardinia, and they can also... maybe they can push back at Spain, take Barcelona maybe, and then get reinforcements from Toulouse and push on further into the Iberian Peninsula. I think that, yeah, that might be it for us. Oh, but ahoy, do I spot? No, we don't really have an opportunity there. Damn it, they've guarded themselves too well. Oh, and here did I just meekly conject that I might be able to just waltz in and seize Venice, but alas, no. If I had a boat here, it would be different, but I don't, so it's not. Oh dear. Well,
your orders, noble one. We shall continue at first light, establishing a tireless watch here, Lord. We will engage them honorably, my lord. Your will, your orders.
Orders. Yes, Lord. This is where we shall meet them.
Oh, Venice doesn't like us. Yeah, we should probably prepare our forces for war against Venice. So like that, I think. Good. Yeah. Ooh, interesting. They're willing to fight us. I'm willing to see what this does. And if we're able to capture Marseille, that will be a fitting end to this episode, I think. War is the greatest plague that can affect humanity. It destroys religion, it destroys states, it destroys families. Any scourge is preferable to it. But here we come. And we have our battle-hardened and experienced light cavalry going up against some European rifle militia. Let's see, their stats. Total defense of 5. That's actually quite good. They also have upgraded armor, as I do see there. We have a defense stat of 10, which is far better. And it also seems weird to me that the Italian light cavalry has a better defense than the general's bodyguard when the general is in plate armor. That's weird to me. If it's trying to, yeah, nerf the bodyguard, I suppose it is, but it seems just such a illogical way to do it. But here we go. And we have taken the general's head. And we take them out. Come on. Yes. Capture as many as you can. There we go.
Our foe has been much humbled. Let all who remember this.
And so Marseille is back into our hands. Oh, and here comes the challenger, though.
Lord, we have conquered.
Okay, so they are aiming to strike back at us. Whether they shall succeed is a matter left in other hands than theirs, though. Benefactor. Oh, Evio de Turin. 68. That's a bit old for an adoption. I'm going to say no to that. I mean, he didn't look terrible, but being so old, I can see no room for him to grow. Let's move some troops into Savoy for security purposes. Let's go for growth in Marseille. Corsica has cavalry stables and has continued on to munitions production, which is excellent. Agrigento. Let's go for some farming.
March ends. Continue tomorrow, my lord. Yes.
Oh, the Moors! They have their eyes on Sardinia, as they often do.
As much as you may wish it, I am not. Accusing me with a diplomat.
The Moroccan cavalry, they have far better defense rating than even the... the bodyguards of noblemen, that seems so strange to me. Not sure I see that logic. But anyway, let's leave the common musketeers. Yes. This army will go to Sardinia and pick up some troops. And see off whatever threat they may have to us. Let's get some line infantry in Agrigento as well, that'll be nice. Henry. Henry. I get why these guys would have low defense, but because it's a simple uniform, they're not wearing armor, really. Any uniform they have only provides moderate protection from, you know, bruises and stuff like that. So I can see their defense wouldn't be very effective, but, you know... When it comes to the armor of royalty, yeah, I just don't get it. Makes no sense to me. But it's okay.
Yes. Orders.
We shall overcome, we shall survive, and we shall thrive. Cavalry training grounds, so you can get reiters. Ooh, gunners on horseback, yes. I think I would like that, so let's push that forward a bit. I dare you to attack my fortress. But whatever they do, we will only know next time around, because now I do have indeed have to run. So, I wish you a wonderful day, Captain Total Waffle.